Hello and welcome back to this channel. Today I'm going to talk about two interesting things. So as we all know that we always have this thing we call IQ, that is emotional, that is intelligence quotient, and then we have EQ, that is emotional quotient. So all these are used to determine different things. EQ has to do with emotions, IQ has to do with intelligence. So both, they deal with intelligence, but in different way. So most people always focus on IQ, and they forget about the EQ. So IQ, mostly, it is used for, it's used to score our intellectual ability, while the most important part that we forget about, which is EQ, is used to determine, or it's kind of a master plan that helps us with the lifelong planning of our emotions. That is, it helps us to control and channel our troublesome emotions in a better way. And so, given this information, we find that 80% of our success is majorly anchored on emotional quotient, while our IQ that we always focus most on only determines 20% of our success in life. So that means that we can't equate intelligence with success, and this is debatable, but that is the truth. So going forward, or moving forward, in this video mostly I want to talk about low emotional intelligence and how you can tell that the person you're interacting with or you yourself, you have low emotional intelligence. And in this video, we're going to look at 9 signs. So in your interactions with the people that you work with, the people you talk to, the people you work with and all those friends, do you know any of them who never seems to be able to control their emotions? Perhaps they are constantly doing or saying the wrong things at the wrong time, or maybe they're always judging others but have a hard time accepting criticism. If this describes someone you know, or even yourself, chances are high that this person or yourself struggles with low emotional intelligence. And so when we're talking about low emotional intelligence, what is low emotional intelligence? So low emotional intelligence is the it refers to the inability to accurately perceive emotions in both yourself and others, and to use that information to guide your thinking and your what? Your actions. So, emotional intelligence, sometimes referred to as the EQ, the one that I was talking about, the EQ and IQ. So, it's essentially basic to our lives, or most aspect, let me say just 100% of our life aspects, because you'll need it in interactions. You'll need it for personal growth and development. So, in fact, many experts now believe that EQ may actually be more important than IQ in determining overall success in life. As such, having low EQ, that is emotional intelligence, as friends, family, coworkers, and even random strangers find themselves embroiled in disputes with these argumentative individuals. People with low EQ will often argue a point to death while refusing to listen to what anyone else has to say, even if you provide them with proof, even if you provide them with the all the facts in this world, they will argue that your point is wrong, all your facts are wrong, whether you have the proof or not. So to win at all cost and find it impossible to simply agree to disagree. This is particularly true if others are critical of how the individual does not understand what others are feeling. So at number three, you are oblivious to others' feelings or other people's feelings. So many people with low EQ are seemingly oblivious to others' feelings. They may be genuinely surprised that their partner is angry at them or that their co-worker don't like them. Not only that, but they get annoyed when others expect them to know how they are feeling. So if you expect somebody who have low emotional intelligence to recognize how you are feeling, then you are looking into in the wrong place, because they don't have that ability to recognize that. At number four, we have insensitive behavior. So people with low emotional intelligence always have this tendency to display insensitive behavior. For the most part, people with low EQ don't know the right thing to say. They may also fail to comprehend appropriate versus inappropriate timing of saying things. So like you find that they say insensitive things at a funeral, or make a joke right after a tragic event. So you see an accident and then somebody makes a joke about the accident. And this can tell you that this person have low emotional intelligence. If you react to their out-of-line response, they act as if you are being overly sensitive. So they will not recognize that you're just being, you're evaluating the environment or the situation before you display your emotions. So they don't have that time themselves. So if you correct them, they will feel like you are overly sensitive towards what has happened. So because they have difficulty understanding the emotions of others, it is no surprise that they are unable to interpret and appropriately respond to the emotional tone and the atmosphere. Emotional tone and the emotional atmosphere. At number five, they use others as scapegoats for their problems. So people with low EQ have little insight into how their emotions might lead to problems. The one thing a person with low emotional intelligence want to do is hold themselves accountable for their actions. And when something goes wrong, their first reaction is to find someone or something else to blame. Yeah. So they might suggest that they had no other choice for what they did, and that others simply don't understand their situations. So an instance is where if they read through your text, nowadays it's so common that people are so curious to know what other people are doing with their phones. So we find that if they read your text, if you left your, maybe you left your phone on the table unlocked, they'll blame you for leaving your phone unlocked. If they fail an assignment, or they might even break a window. If they don't get the job or burn dinner somehow or some way, they will make it someone else's fault. And this is something that they have made perfect on their side. So they won't be able to recognize that this is about them and it's their fault and not your fault. Yeah. So at number five, they display poor coping skills. Number six, that is, they display poor coping skills. An ability to cope with emotionally charged situations can be an indicator of low emotional intelligence. Strong emotions whether their own or those of others, are difficult to comprehend for those with low emotional intelligence. These individuals will often walk away from these situations to avoid having to deal with the emotional fallout. Hiding their true emotions is also very common. So people with low emotional intelligence will rather walk out to avoid the fallout instead of dealing with what is going on head on and express themselves, because they walk out because they fear doing what? They fear dealing with other people's emotions, and they might appear like they are happy sometimes, but that is just something they display on the outside, but on the inside it's totally a different story. So they hide their real emotions. They might say, okay, I'm really happy for you, but they're not really that happy for you. They might say that I've forgiven you and I don't feel bad anymore, but deep down they really feel bad. So people with low emotional intelligence will always try to either hide or mask those emotions. So at number 7, they always tend to have and call for emotional outbursts, and the ability to regulate emotions is one of the components of emotional intelligence, and it basically makes the bigger part of emotional intelligence, because we learn to, when you have high emotional intelligence, it means that you have high control of your emotions, that is the most troublesome emotions. And so people with low emotional intelligence always tend to have an uncalled for emotional outburst, because they often struggle to understand and control their emotions. They might lash out reactively without understanding what they are really feeling or what they are so upset about. The smallest things set them off into a tirade that can last for minutes or hours. So I find that it is very difficult to make a point to them or just have a conversation with them, especially if it's one that will be emotionally charged, because they are prone to this kind of outbursts. At number 8, they also struggle with relationships. So people with low EQ often have very few close friends. This is because close friendships, as it is universal, close friendships require a mutual give and take kind of thing. They also require sharing of emotions, that is, they also require compassion and emotional support. All these characteristics are very low in people with low EQ. So these tend to be their major hindrance to having even intimate relationships with people. And they typically lack it, that is. So instead, people with this low EQ, instead of having the four major components or four major characteristics, they will always often come off as very abrasive people, abrasive and unfeeling. So you look at them and you wonder whether they have feelings or not. And it might be a little bit confusing, but they don't have it in them. So at number 9, which is the last one, people with low emotional intelligence always turn most, if not all, of the conversations towards themselves. So emotionally unintelligent people tend to dominate, that is, if you start a conversation, they'll always want to dominate the whole conversation, even if they are asking questions and appear to be listening intently. They always find a way to shift everything back to them usually they have to prove that whatever you are experiencing, they have had it better or worse. No matter what you say, they've been there, done that, you've been in a car accident, so they have to, and their dog died, or one of their friends died. So going to maybe do something new, or maybe you're going to try to maybe climb a hill or climb a mountain, or maybe you're going to learn how to skate or something like that. They've always done that. They've had a fair share of what comes with them. And so you realize that they might really end up even exaggerating all these things that maybe you've gone through so that it can fit the emotional space, so that maybe this thing turns around and it be like, so you had an accident, your dog died, or you had an accident, you had an injury, but for them, they had an accident, their dog died, a person they loved got an injury, and it really drained them, maybe emotionally. So you'll stop feeling what you are feeling to feel sorry for them, and now the whole all of this thing turns out to be not about you who was supposed to express their feelings, but it turns out to be about them who this conversation was not about. So these are some of the 9 signs of low emotional intelligence. I hope this video was helpful to you and it has opened your eyes towards realizing how emotional intelligence can be determined. So if you like this video, please share, like it also on the like button. Please, if you are not a subscriber, please consider subscribing, and I hope this information helps you in one way or another, or your friends, or helps you in your interactions with different individuals. So thank you for watching, and bye for today.